Hello, 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 hello. Good evening, folks. Good evening, folks. Good evening there, Frank. Yes, I can see you there, Frank. Good evening. Good evening, man. good evening there, Biker Boz, channel contributor, people that are new to the room. If you come in later on and you see this live stream later on down the road, anyone's name that is highlighted in green and I give a shout out to, please go and check out those channels. They are channel contributors. Thank you very much, Biker Boz. Good evening. Good evening there, Dean. How you doing, bruv? Good to see you, man. Good to see you. Hope everyone's doing good down there in Israel. Good evening there, Alan. How you doing, man? Ming. Ah, yes. Good evening, Ming. Good evening, man. Good to see you. And good evening there, Mr. Waspy. Good to see you, man. And we have Equinox MCB in the room, channel contributor. Please go and check out these channel contributors, please. And we have got Vasco in the room, Vasco FMDC. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Mr. Vasco, channel contributor. Please check these channels out. Good evening there, Liam. And we have Liam, Mr. Teller, in the house this evening there, moderating the chat. Drum roll, please. Good evening there, Tom Holmes. How you doing, man? Good to see you. Smoking Bob, good evening, man. Good evening. John Spritzer, another channel contributor. Thank you very much, man. Thank you very much. Please go and check out these channels when their names are highlighted. And channel contributors, please feel free to drop your channel URLs in the live stream or in the comment section before, during, or after the live stream. Good evening there, Enigma. How you doing, geez? Good to see you. Can anyone tell me if this comment works? YouTube ban me from making comments. You're coming through loud and clear here, man. You're coming through loud and clear here. HR says, Dibber in the wind. Ah! Yeah, we can see it, Enigma. Absolutely, says Mr. Equinox. We can see it. Good evening there, Mark Mizzy. How you doing, bruv? Good to see you. Good to see you. Joker's there in Malta. Was having a chat with your president and that conversation we had, Mark. Yeah. Going to be talking to you in a video chat, yeah? Going to be bringing some of my stuff to do a live stream. Skanker McNacker, good evening. Good to see you, man. Hey there, Dibba. I hope you're all is good with you. Yeah, it's all good. All good, man. Thad Jackson, another channel contributor. Please, people, check these channels out, please. Afternoon, Dibba from Oklahoma. Good evening there, man. Good evening, bruv and crew. Good evening there, Dean. Good evening there, Greg McBee says, hello, Dibba Enigma. Dib, if the comment working, I did a workaround. Good on you, Ignima. Good on you, man. Marky says, perfect. Absolutely, man. Casey Biker says, evening, Dibba, from Cork. Good evening there in Cork. Hope you're doing well. Alan Church, another channel contributor. Please, people, check out these channels, please. And channel contributors, you are free to drop your channel URLs in the stream or in the comment section before, during, or after the live stream, whenever the comment section is available. Right, okay, so some big birthdays this past week, yeah, on St. Patrick's Day. So St. Patrick's Day, yeah, happy St. Patrick's Day to all of my Irish friends around the world, yeah, and across there on the Emerald Isle, of which I've got a lot that, you know, support this channel a hell of a lot, yeah? So what I want to do is, before we get on with throwing the room open for open chat this evening, I just want to wish some happy birthdays to two motorcycle clubs, yeah? I want to wish my friends across there on the Emerald Isles, the Devil's Disciples MC Ireland, the Devil's Disciples MC Northern Ireland, the MC, yeah, Devil's Disciples MC Nomads. The Skanker McNacker's in the room. He's already here. Let's support your local 440 DMC Ireland. Go on, go for it, Skanker. Go on. Yeah, and also, yeah, big 44 to them. 44 years, man. 44 years as an MC, a 1%er. Excellent, excellent. Right, and also to the 81 Hells Angels MC, which are now HAMC World. Yeah, 75 years, 75 years. this club has been together and they have grown and grown and grown. And there was a comment that was once made on the BBC that if they ever managed to amalgamate across all of the UK, kind of God help us sort of attitude. Well, it happened. So yeah, happy 75th to the big HAMC, the big red machine. Right, so we're going to throw the floor open this evening. So what are we going to yabber about this evening? Okay, back at you, honour and respect, says Enigma. So what are we going to do this evening, eh? What are we going to chat about? What are we going to chat about? Anybody want me to shout out any runs or rallies that they got going? Go on, come on. Anything you want to throw up there this evening, it's an open floor. KC Biker says, congratulations, Devil's Disciples. I can never pronounce your name, the Crows MCC from Cork Island. Thank you for doing that. I can never pronounce your name. Having issues my end, going to log out and back in again. Okay, Liam, you do what you have to do, man. Otherwise, I'll just have to take care of things my end, mate. New Star Trek. Do you know, I haven't seen any new Star Trek, so I can't even comment on it. What about someone joining a club out without where their love just to get a workaround because they were banned from the inner city? Can you lay that out a little bit more clearer? What about someone joining a club out of where they love just to get out? A work round, just so you're gonna have to get that a little bit clearer. Casey Biker, an Alliance Island support club. Ah, yes, I know, yeah. Send Flowers, haven't watched you since around 2018. Crikey, welcome back, Send Flowers. Just got this notification that you was live. Going to see you're still on YouTube, Dibba. Hope you have a great Sunday, pal. Oh, thank you very much. Send flowers. What name were you on before? Oh, Send Flowers. Come on. Who was you before? Congrats, MC, with the anniversary. Absolutely. Mark Mizzy, I'm sitting here removing the rear wheel off my pig to get it trued, so I'm happy to listen to you at the moment. Oh, thank you very much, Mark. Google Translate, says Dean. You know it, man. Right, it says, lad I know, he was banned from joining the inner city MCC, but instead joined the same club, but in a different city. You shouldn't be allowed to do that. Absolutely not. No, you shouldn't. You shouldn't do that. Absolutely not. And massive congrats and birthdays to you all. Love, loyalty, honor, and respect, says Mark. Oh, that's going out to the DDs and the big red machine. What the hell is going on with England with these quiet zones, no vehicles allowed? Don't know, there ain't none around where I live, John. I live out in the countryside, mate. That's why I'm thankful. You know, I've got all these miles and miles and miles of lanes around where I live, yeah, which is where I take my ride outs, and I take my ride outs on my bike, and I take you lot along with me. I tell you, I am surrounded. I've got hundreds of miles, literally hundreds of miles of country lanes surrounding me. I do not need to get onto those roads with all the cameras and stuff. I just don't. I don't know why there hasn't been any fallback considering its main support, MCC. It's down to that club, though, Equinox. It's not any business of mine, man. It's the business of that club, you know. It's for them to take care of their own business, you know, and that's just how it is. In Somerset, says John. Oh, right. Okay. There's plenty of country roads out around in Somerset. But then again, I haven't been down that way for a long, long time. I've got family down there and I haven't visited them for a long time. had a little fallout with them, and I haven't been back since. Good evening there, Daisy. Good evening. Thank you very much. Another channel contributor. Please, people, check out my channel contributor channels. If they make content, please subscribe and show support to them, yeah? And my channel contributors, as always, you're free to leave your channel URLs in the comments or in the live stream. Send flowers. I never commented on anything. I just used to watch a lot of your videos because when I was 17, 18, the plan was to prospect for a club my family's involved in. Love from Leicester. Oh, okay, send flowers. Okay, welcome back. You, Liz. Yes, LTNs. Yes. I think we've already touched on the U-less thing now, haven't we? I think we've already made our feelings known on that one. But there was a big demonstration down in London, I believe, this weekend. I didn't see much reporting on it on any news outlets. So, yes, you have to wonder whose side the news outlets are on. Could talk about why YouTube censored you. I wouldn't know, Enigma. Probably you said something they didn't like, man. You have to be real careful with YouTube these days, you know. You really do, man. Alan Church says he feels sorry for those in Greater London and ULEZ. You know, I just can't understand it. I can't see how it's going to save the planet. It's just another big con, as far as I see. Another just money grab. You know, they want to. You know what they want to do next? This one, they want to tax you on tires. They want a tire tax, yeah, because of the particulates that come off of tires, yeah, and also the carbon that comes off of tires, yeah. So they want to start, you know, they want to start doing tax on that as well. Now it's crazy, man. It's gone well, it's gone mad. Dare I ask why the dislike for... yeah, Birdo, much love, loyalty, honor, and respect. Thad Jackson, Dibber, how can I send you a private message? Let's put it this way. You can send, there's a number of ways you can send me a private message, Thad. You can respond to any posts that I put on my community post part of my YouTube channel. Anytime you comment on any video, yeah, it's held for review. And if you want to leave a comment there, you can do it that way, yeah? And my channel moderator will let me know that there's a comment waiting for me to read, yeah? A personal message. You can do it that way, yeah? Or you can come across to Facebook and look for me on Dibber39 and send me a private message on Facebook. That's one of the ways you can do it. There's several ways you can send me a private message. Tax brake pads next. They'll reduce pollution. You know it, Waspy. They're going to do it. They're going to come after everything, man. When you're going to do something on Rumble, cross over the dark side. Actually, I'll tell you what, Robbo, I'm actually waiting for a little piece of hardware that plugs into my other laptop. Yeah, my other laptop is much, much more up to date than this one. And I have to use a third party software, you know, to live stream over on there, and it requires the latest this and the latest that. So I've got to get this little adapter so that I can hardwire that laptop into the internet hub instead of using it on Wi-Fi, because apparently it works better when it's hardwired. And then I've got to have the USB for my mic and then one for my camera. So yeah, I've just got to wait for this little bit of hardware to come that I can plug into one of the USB ports and use it as a hard wire for my internet. And then we're going to start sussing out how to use the software for that. Nor pray corn. I should know. I hang around with a lot of Irish people. Uh, I just checked on the last video I liked yours was from 2015, not 2018. So been a really long time. Crikey, yeah, has it? Only just now passed the CBT. Well, at least you've done it, yeah? And was going to get a Keyway Superlight. Any other 125 recommendations? Yeah, anything except for a Chinese bike, man. Get a decent little 125 Honda. They do some nice little cruisers, 125s. Yeah, they do some nice little bikes, 125s. Get a Suzuki or something, you know, or a Yamaha. Just get something that isn't one of them Chinese ones. I'd take that splatter as a no. You know it, Equinox, man. No, I ain't got no time for those things, man. If Adele's part of the woke brigade, let's hope she's not on the other side. On the other side of what? Sorry. If Adele's part of the woke brigade, let's hope she's not on the other side. Sorry, am I missing something here? Has something been said earlier on? No, no, hang on, no. Okay. Robbo, come and see me on Facebook then, man. Hey, I took your advice and got a Facebook account. Come and see me on Facebook, yeah, and I'll send you a link to that Maltese Facebook page that does all the stuff about the military over there in Malta, man. So I bet they'd be interested in some of that stuff with your dads. Literally means the crows. Ah, yeah, nice one, man. Perfect pronunciation. Ah, thank you very much. Rommet. Yeah, that one that Tony has, bombproof. You know it, Liam, man. That I'll tell you what, that Rommet has been there. It's seen it and, you know, whew. Oh, when Enigma referred to Rumble as the dark side, yeah, it is the dark side, isn't it? I've just got to get a bit of hardware for my other laptop because it's the most up-to-date one I've got with, like, the most RAM and all the rest of it. And then once I suss that software out, then I'm going to do some dark side over on Rumble. We'll do it. We'll do the streams here, you know, like I said, and then we'll go over to the dark side and we'll do some dark stuff over there. Biker Boss. Ah, Biker Boss, channel contributor. Thank you very much, man. People, please check out my channel contributors when I shout out. Yeah, if their name's highlighted in green and you've just visited the chat, please go and check out those channels. Yeah. And Biker Boss says, evening, Dibbert, what's afoot tonight? Same as it was last night. Go on. You know I'm going to do it. You know I'm going to do it, didn't you? You just fucking know I'm going to do it. Go on. It's 12 inches, man. What did Liam say? Yeah, that Rommet is bombproof. You know it. It is too, isn't it, Mark? Frippin' hell, man. Moto Noggin. Hello, Moto Noggin. Welcome to the chat room. Biker Boss, you know it. That was a good one, wasn't it? I got there's friends of mine, yeah, over on Facebook, yeah. And if they leave an open-ended comment, and I know a few of you have suffered the consequences of leaving open-ended comments of me coming in and then just writing a whole load of fucking shit just to get a reaction. Kawasaki KDX420, a very fast dirt bike. Oh, yeah, nice. Kawasaki always did make good dirt bikes. I wouldn't actually know. No, I always preferred Yamahas actually for dirt bikes. I'll tell you what, Liam, those Rommets, man. I'll tell you what, that Rommet has been to hell and back. I'm not joking, right? And Mark will back me up on that. That little bike has been to hell and back. And it is still going. It's having to have a little bit of another rebuild, I believe, at the moment, but it's still going. It's still going about 30 centimetres, says Waspy. He's at it. Depends where you come from, 12 inches small. When you start doing dark stuff on Rumble, do we have to call you Darth Dibber? Yeah, shall I put on the black mask? Any good rallies anyone could suggest? All my usual ones seem to all be cancelling this year. Really, Equinox B? Really? Well, if your people are doing rallies or whatever this year, throw up the dates and what have you. Yeah, throw it up in the live stream. Yeah, throw it up in the live stream or after the live stream. You can stick it in a comment, put a link to your Facebook page, whatever. Obviously, my moderator, I'll just let him know that I've left an open door for people to do it. If you're putting on a rally, a show this year, whatever, feel free, post up a link to your Facebook page, yeah, and share the links, yeah? Do it that way. Do it in the comments, whatever. Good evening there, Zinger, channel contributor. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Good evening, good evening. Right, so what are we going to chat about now? Because any suggestions? Got some good secret stuff coming up. Got a chat with Marky in here. I'm gonna have a little chat with him, but we've got some secret stuff coming up. Yeah, when I go to the island, we're going to be doing some stuff. There's going to be some stuff for those people, obviously. Tone Deaf, hey, Dibber in the Wind and all. Hey there, Tone Deaf. Right, so what's going to happen is when I go out to see them, there's going to be some bits and pieces going on. There's going to be some live stream stuff going on that's going to be done through my YouTube channel, and it will be shared through the Joker's MCC Facebook page. And through all their links, there'll also be some of the stuff that's going to be behind the scenes type stuff, which is going to be more private, which will be for the people that are channel contributors. As always, I do some raw stuff behind the scenes that they get to see before any editing or anything gets done, so that they'll get that stuff. But yeah, there's going to hopefully be a stream that I'm going to stream from my channel. And it will go through the Joker's Facebook and through their links and everything else as well. So, yeah, that should be good. Should be good. People get another little look at how things are done somewhere else. Really cool. What's this? A foul mouth doesn't mean everything tastes of chicken. Oh, come on, you can do better than that one. Do you want a coat? Go and get your coat. Go on, go and get your coat. Off you go. terrible that one. So what we're going to talk about, or I'm going to do the off-ski. Yeah, what we got? Evening Dib. Oh, the military biker. Good evening, military biker. How you doing, man? Hope you're keeping well. I'll get my coat and gloves, says Tone Deaf. Yeah, that was a bad one, man. That was bad. Dream bike. God, dream bike. Do you know, I spoke about this before, you know. Dream bike. I would like a motorcycle custom built to my specifications, right, by Arch Motorcycles. Keanu Reeves motorcycles, yeah. That's what I'd like. I'd like a bike built by him. I'd like just to have the money to be able to buy one of those. the hand, it's all healed up now. Wow. It's left a few scars, man, but it's, yeah, it's healed up. Yeah, it's healed up. The hand's healed up now. Yeah, that's what I would like. Military biker says, doing well, mate. Thanks. Winter is finally coming to an end over here. Yes, it's starting to do that here now. Riding season is about to start. Yeah. Yeah, I was out having a tinker with mine, yeah. Dion Jones, what do I think about Yamaha VMAX? Any experience? Never had experience. I know a couple of people who have had them. I know one of my friends had nothing but trouble with one that he had, but obviously, I know people that have had them and sworn by them. So, but I've never had one. And as I've never had one, I can't really make any comment on it. Biker Boz says never a season. You know it, man. Tone deaf. My last bike was a Triumph Daytona 955i. Oh, in Aston Green Triple. Oh, lovely. Oh, yes, I saw your photos there. Well, it's been a nice weekend on the coast. I saw you, I saw your pictures, man. So you're getting out and about, yeah? Yamaha R1. Oh, you know it, Enigma. Yeah, good bikes, man. Good bikes. I have ridden one of those. They're psycho machines. Good fun. Absolutely. rally you would like to attend over in North America? None of them, because they're all corporate. They're all corporate. They're not like over here. They're not run by clubs like they are over here. It's all corporate, mate. Wouldn't be interested in any of that. That'd piss me right off. I think corporate shouldn't be involved in our life. I used to sell Yamaha V-Max and Yamaha products. The V-Max is a very comfortable, very fast bike. Oh, thank you very much for that feedback, John. I can't answer it because I've never had one. Amazing power when they work. Awful for handling, but a few tweaks can fix the V-Max easy. Oh, there's some V-Maxy people in here. Nice one. Share the knowledge, man. Share the knowledge. Definitely a season for us in Canada. Yes. Military biker. Yeah, he's in Canada. Yeah, I wouldn't fancy that. Yeah, definitely wouldn't fancy that. I'd have to have a dirt bike for that. Definitely a little two-stroke dirt bike, I think. Love the R1. The R1s are a good bike. I've ridden one. I've ridden the R6s as well. They're a nice little bike too. As long as it's not a Virago, it should be a good bike, other than the Chinese. Thad Jackson says, Harley Street Glide. Never had one. Can't make a comment on it. Mark Mizzy says, I personally have an 07 Rocket. Oh, lovely. Nice. Tom Holmes says, our 10th anniversary is coming up on the 20th to the 21st of May at the Rag Pub, Thurtles, Tipperary, Vulcan Riders, Ireland. Yeah, Tom, put a link to somewhere where people can see the poster, man, when the live stream's finished, yeah? Feel free, put up a link to the poster, yeah? Or the Facebook page or whatever. I means fuel injection. ever had a Kawasaki VN dibber? Yes, I have, Dion. I had a VN 800 Classic. Absolutely loved it. Absolutely loved it. The only problem with them was, and you had to, once you got them sussed, yeah? So you know, I see people, they get the wobbles and it scares the shit out of them. But those VNs, you can get them. I mean, you know, you got a VN. Like I say, VN 800 Classic is the one I had. And you get that thing top end and you get that ragging and you get your body position right. You can get that arse end so it's fishing like a fish's tail, man, but you're still going in a straight line. Lovely bikes. Loved it, man. Honda VFR 750 RC24. You know it, Equinox. Love those bikes, man. No, you had one, Dibs. Love those machines. Still got it too. Easy keeps up with a lot of the newer bikes. I tell you what, I had the Mark One, the very first one that they ever had. Hey, Gadget Ireland in the house. Congratulations. 44 years, Devil's Disciples Ireland. Well done. Well done, Gadge. Big congratulations to you and all your brothers, yeah? Big, big congratulations, man. But then VFR 750s, like I say, I had a Mark One. And it was in pearlescent white. It was the original FG, the first one. They were a bit weak-kneed on the front end. The front forks weren't beefy enough. They did an update on them on the next model. They kept everything exactly the same. They just changed the front forks, made it a little bit more sturdy. But the first one I had, I sent it away and I had a whole lot of stuff done to it so that the engine matched the paintwork. Because I had it all done in Rothmans Honda colours, all done proper. at Dream Machine, who did the On the Racing team colours at the time. And yeah, that was fast. That was fast. I love the VFRs. I love them. I just come off a VN 1600 to a Harley. I have multiple VN 1600s, really good running bikes. I love them, John. I like them. They're good bikes, the VNs. I like them. You know, you can do lots and lots of miles on those. The seats on them are just absolutely perfect. I wish I had the same seat on my Suzuki as I had on my Kawasaki. That seat was real nice, real comfortable. I used to be able to sit in that thing all day long. Up the Irish St. Paddy's Day. You know it, Tone Deaf. You know it, man. Skanga McNacker, up Tone Deaf. Still have a Z1000 1983 core gadge. Now that's a machine, man. That is a machine. I know people that would absolutely, you know, murder for one of those. I know people that would literally to get hold of one of those. Yeah, that's a serious piece of kit, man. I wouldn't mind one of those myself. Bit of Mad Max. Dion says, I'd love another bike, but no shed or garage these days. Reckon of keeping one outside in the backyard. Get yourself a ground anchor, you know, dig a dirty, great big hole, fill it with concrete. Yeah, put a ground anchor in there, steel ground anchor, and get yourself one of those locks that you can get more information about over on Biker Biker on Facebook. Yeah, they did a video over there where they did comparisons. There was a group did comparisons on which were the most effective locks and stuff if you want to lock your bikes up and make it very difficult for bike thieves. So go across to Biker Biker. They did a whole load of video about it. Gadget says, I'll send you pictures as soon as possible. Yeah, that'd be cool, Gadget. That'd be cool, man. That'd be cool to see that. Skanker McNacker. Oh, he's talking to somebody else. Go to my VN1600, add stock seat, never change them. Yeah, very comfortable. They were a very, very comfortable machine. I wish I'd never got rid of mine now, but I got rid of mine because there was some memories in it, yeah? And at the time, I was really, really ill, and I weren't allowed to ride. And it used to gut me to see the bike sitting there, not doing nothing. And the memories, you know, that I had with the bike, and then I sold it. And then when I started getting better, I wish I'd never sold it. So, yeah, it's just one of those things, isn't it? Good advice on the ground anchor and the lock. How about a cover? Just an Oxford one. Yeah, get one of those Oxford ones, yeah? One of those ones that got the UV protection on them as well, yeah? But you also want one that's got air vents, yeah? Because you get damp caught in underneath it, you know, you still get rust, you know? Last year sold Eddie Lawson's replica. Oh, yeah, all right, Gadge, all right. what year was your VN 800? Oh, God. I don't know. It was the VN 800 Classic. I had it in, oh, God. I don't know how old it was. There's pictures of it on here in my videos, in the intros of my old videos. There's pictures of it. I can't remember how old it was. Good evening there, Vivid. Another channel contributor. Please, people, check out my channel contributor channels. Yeah, and as I said earlier, channel contributors, you are free to post your URLs in the live stream or the comment section after the live stream. Evening, Dibber. Good evening. Good evening, Vivid. Gadgets love it. I see your posts. I see your posts where you post up those delicious, lovely looking motorcycles, regular as clockwork. I see those post, Gadget. I don't miss them, man. I sit there sometimes and think to myself, fuck it, I would love that. I would love that. But then, you know, I know that I can't get into a conversation where I say I'd love that because I know you'll be going, hey, yeah, come on, Deborah, come over and take a look at it, man. You know you fall in love with it. Yeah, yeah, and that's the problem. Is anyone into old muscle cars? No, not really. I know they are over in Malta. They love them over there. They love that sort of stuff. But not me. It's not my thing, man. You know, not my thing. They don't do nothing for me. I'm a biker, man. For me, the car is just a necessity. He's Jamaican, got to work on personality. Not with fuel, £2 a litre. Yeah, a car's good for shopping. That's it, Tone Deaf. I just use it for shopping. That's it, you know. I've got arthritis, you know. I've done so many years riding through the winter, you know. I've done so many years riding through the winter that I think I've earned it, you know. 1.67 litre here. Come on, Gadge. No, I've got my car. I've got my little Renault. Cost me £30 a year to tax. And it's good to go shopping in when I need to go shopping. Ride the bike, sleep in the van. Wide Boy HRF Pro. Evening from Wide Boys Lambretta Club. Oh, good evening there, Wide Boys Lambretta Club. Hope you're keeping well, yeah? Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the chat. Electric heated gloves. Kiss that man that invented those Equinox Cup. Do you know, I never had a pair of those. Do you know, I never ever had a pair of those. When I had my very first VFR, right, the guy that bought it had it before me, he literally had it 2 years. He barely rode it, yeah. He had everything done to it, yeah. Had all the, you know, mega extra cool stainless pipes and everything put on it, you know. He did everything to it. Heated handlebar grips, and, you know, never once did I switch those handlebar grips on. Never once. I've got osteoarthritis in my right ankle. I get, yeah, you know it, Tone Deaf. It hurts, man. I got quite a rare one, man. I've got quite a rare one. Those people have been following me on here for a long time. They know about it all. Equinox B says, worth it. Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, nowadays, I'd probably use them. But back them days, nah, definitely not. And still, no, I still don't use anything now. You know, the way I look at it is now, if my hands don't hurt and I can ride, I go and ride my bike, yeah? As soon as they start hurting, I just park it up, get my hands warm, and then once I can ride again, I ride. What are you talking about, Nick? You fucking lost me there, man. Mine are collectible. 65 vet and my dad's. Oh, you're talking about cars, man. Sorry, man, you lost me. You lose me, man, when you start talking about cars. Cars are good for people who don't have motorcycles, says John. Like, I literally have mine because I've got a bone disease and, you know, I'd be fucked without it when my bones decide to play up like they have been doing because it's been cold and wet, you know. But then, you know, when you spent your life on a bike bouncing down the road, you've been, you know, in intensive care, woken up with, you know, tubes coming out of every orifice and you've got metal plates and shit throughout your body and what have you, then, you know, you've earned the right to have four wheels when you get to the fucked up age. Well, that's the way I see it. Spent most of the winter at the traffic lights with hands clamped to the engine block. Yeah, you know it, Waspy. Crikey, man. Yeah, I'd be screwed if my hands, well, if my hands get too cold now, they just lock up. I'd be screwed. Vidvid says, back then we could ride 200 miles in the snow in waxed waterproof. Yeah, not cotton, black jackets. They were white waterproofs. Yeah. God, crikey. Do you know, I used to ride literally hundreds and hundreds of miles. I didn't care about the weather. The weather, I just really, really didn't give a stuff. Didn't bother me in the slightest. I always used to have two pairs of gloves, right? And I always used to sit one pair. If I was riding like the VFR, I used to be able to wedge a glove down either side, yeah, of the fairing around near the engine. And it used to get that pair of gloves warm. And then when my hands got intolerably cold and it got to the point where I was almost screaming with pain with the cold in my hands, I'd switch the gloves over and put that cold pair down in that place and then put the nice warm pair on. And I'd still carry on riding, you know. I'd pull up at home, you know, and I'd have ice down the front of my jacket and on the front of my crash helmet. I used to ride in all those sort of conditions. I used to do it. I used to have to ride to work in the snow and the ice because I didn't have any other form of transport. Tone deaf. What do you call a laughing motorcycle? A Yamaha. Oh, God, here we go. So, someone give Tone deaf his jacket. Come on. Hand him his jacket. Come on. Give him his gloves. Off him out. Come on. I disliked heated grips. Make your palms boiling and freeze your fingers. Horrid. And when you shake your hands. Yeah, I know what you mean, yeah. Wide boy pro, black bin liners with holes for your head and arms. Yeah, I've seen that done, yeah. I've seen that done on long runs. Keep the water out. Yeah, absolutely. But the problem is, what people don't realise is that if you don't get air flowing, yeah, inside your... whatever you're wearing on cold, and this is a mistake a lot of people make, yeah, you start to sweat. And then when you stop, the sweat starts to get cold, and then you get even colder still. So, yeah, it's a happy medium, you know, and it takes you a long time to get it sussed out, the happy medium. Because if you sweat, and then you get cold. You get cold. You get cold, cold. Used to get funny looks at the service stations with hot air blower down the trousers, just trying to encourage. You have to use the engine blocks as biker balls, yeah. Enigma says, I forgot I was on a bike show. Apologies, temporary brain fart. You know it, man. Cars, they're only used as a necessity, man. Oh, dear. I don't mind watching them going down a drag strip. You know, I don't mind watching those type. You know, because there's always the chance something could go for tits up and everything could go sideways, you know. But no, it's not my scene. Not my scene. Nah. Oh. Right, we've been here 43 minutes, 44 minutes. I'm going to do the off-ski in a minute anyway, because I want something to eat. I just wanted to come in, check in with everyone, make sure everyone was all right, make sure everybody's all good. Yeah, get a Ducati, Vidvid. Crutch will be glowing red by the time you get home, says Equinox. What's the difference between a vacuum cleaner, a lawyer on a motorcycle? The vacuum cleaner has the dirt bag on. Someone give Tone Deaf his jacket, please. And someone escort Tone Deaf to the door. Show him out. Show him the exit. Tell him he can come back when he's got a better attitude. or a better joke book. Anyway, folks, I'm going to do the off-ski. It's been... I heard that, but yes, yes, yes. Are you sure selling the house for half a mil? No, no, but no, there's no cars, man. Not into cars, thank you. Nothing like riding home on a bike at 3 a.m. after the bar closes and you're so cold you can't get off your bike. Yeah, I've been that way. Yeah, I've done that. Hey, the process. Good, good. Hey, you're a bit late, man. I'm just signing out. Please, people, go and check out the channels that are highlighted in green. These people are my channel contributors. And as I say, channel contributors, feel free to put your channel links in the comments section when I finish the stream. Yeah. Anyway, look, I'm going to do the off-ski. I will say all of my channel contributors, thank you very, very much, yeah, for all your continued support. Yeah. It is greatly, greatly appreciated. It's going towards what I'm doing in May. So, yeah, massive, massive thanks. And a big massive thanks to everyone that has come in the room this evening, participated in the chat. The chats wouldn't be worth doing without you people coming in and participating in them. So I shall bid you all good night and happy 44 to Devil's Disciples MC Ireland and Northern Ireland and their Nomad chapter, and happy 75th to the Big Red Machine HA MC Hell's Angels World. From me, good night. Peace out.